In first part of forms of business organization, we have discussed or you see related the sole proprietorship, partnership and joint Hindu family business. The other part of partnership that we have discussed in this second part. Kinds of partners. The partners are classified into four parts based upon different points. The first is based upon extent of participation, that again divided into two parts, active partner and sleeping partner. Second, based on sharing of the profit, that also divided into two parts, nominal partner and partners in profit. Next, based on liability, that also divided into two parts, limited partner, general partner. Based on nature of behavior, that divided into two parts, that is partner by estoppel, partner by holding out. So that see one by one. First, active partner. He takes an active part in the management of the firm's business and bears unlimited liability for the debits of the firm. Like other partner, an active partner also contribute capital to the firm. It is actively acts in firm. Next, sleeping or inactive partner. The sleeping of inactive partner does not take part in any management of the firm business. He however contribute capital and share profits or losses of the firm. His liability of the debits of firm is unlimited. Means what? You have seen in the screen, the one picture is there, one person is sleeping. So why that in the mind, I gave 3000 rupees as in silent partner, so I don't have to do anything. The person is inactive in the firm, that means a sleeping or inactive partner. Next is nominal partner. He only lends his name to the firm as a partner. He however neither invests any capital nor claims any share in the profit of the business. Through, he does not take part in the management of the firm business. He bears unlimited liability for the debits incurred by the firm. Means he as a nominal person, for the just sake of documentary word, other than that, profit or capital investment is not shared to with that person. Next, partner in the profit only. He invests his capital only with the earn a share in the profit of the firm and has no liability as regard to any losses suffered by him. His liability for the firm debits is however unlimited. Means this person invests the capital only for earning a money, means only for profit. Next, secret partner. A partner who does not want the fact of his being a partner to be known to the outsider is known as secret partner. Means third person are invest in the business like as a secret partner. For documentary purpose, they are not act as an the partner. That partner is a secret partner. His liability of firm debits is however unlimited. Next, minor partner. A partner below the age of 18, being a minor, does not enjoy the rights of full-fledged partner in the partnership firm, since in law he is not compelled to contract. However, the Indian Partnership Act allows the minor as a partner if all other partner agreed to it. If other partner is agreed for some person that having age less than 18 or 18, just a young boy, so that person is a minor partner. A minor partner has entitled to share in the profit and property of the firm. His liability of the firm debit is however limited in the proportion to his share in the profit and property of the firm. Means those profit earned in the firm that have limited for the minor partner. Next, partner by estoppel. If outsider behave in the such fashion that he is mistaken as a partner of the firm by third party investment or third party, he held liable to all those third party who extend credit to the firm on the assumption of his being partner. Means some partner has invested in the third partner that actually not a part of partnership. Okay, because of such person is known as partner by estoppel. Because of his having behaved as a partner, he cannot deny the liability attaching to the position of the partner. In actual practice, a partner by estoppel is not a partner of the firm. It is not actual partner of the firm, but it invests money by second or third person to the firm. He neither contribute any capital or not take part in the management of firm. He not contribute any capital or does not take part in the management of firm. Kinds of partnership. From the point of view of liability of the partner, partnership may be divided into two parts. First, general partnership. Second, limited partnership. In general partnership, in the general partnership, the liability of every partner is unlimited. In case of assets of the firm are not sufficient to pay off its liability, even the private property of the partner may be used to meet the undischarged liability. Means, in case firm is not sufficient to pay the liability, even in the private property, that time some person acts as a partnership, that person is a general partner that assist the whole partnership. Next, however, a minor partner is an exception. Minor partner is an exception because his liability of firm is obligation is limited to the portion of his share and profit and capital, because the limited portion of share and profit give to minor partner. Next, each partner of general partnership is entitled to participate in the management of the business unless the partner themselves decide otherwise. General partnership, those are general partner, that partner is manage the firm management, okay, or business. Limited partnership, the limited liability or limited partnership, the unlimited liability of the partners in the general partnership discourage investment of large sums in the firms. That's why the limited partnership is way out of this difficulty, although it is not permitted under the Indian law. Means in unlimited partnership or in general unlimited liability in general partnership that have somewhat effect on the firm. That's why limited partnership is in the form. Next, the main feature of such partnership. First, a limited partnership consists of two classes of partner. First, general partner with unlimited liability and special or limited partner with their liabilities limited to their capital contribution. Special partner cannot assign his share to an outsider without the consent of the general partner. Those having a special partner in limited partnership cannot assign his share to outsider without consent with the general partner. Next, limited partner. simply invests his money in the fray. Though he is not entitled to take part in the management of the business, he is allowed to inspect the books of the firm from this information. Those having a limited partner are directly not involved in management of business, but he can inspect the firm books for this information. The death, Lawrence, and bankruptcy of limited partner will not affect as an existence of the firm in any way, as such limited partnership is more stable than general partnership firm. So after death or any problem, partnership will not dissolve. So stable business we can run. Next, a special partner cannot withdraw any part of the capital contributed by him. If he does so, his liability on the portion so withdrawn becomes unlimited. If the special partner cannot withdraw any money that are invested in the firm, okay, if he does it, so his liability or portion withdrawal become unlimited. Next, difference between sole proprietorship business and partnership business. Single person is the owner of the business in sole proprietorship. In second part, partnership, there are two or more person, up to maximum 20% can join together to run business. Second point, the business is managed and controlled by proprietor in sole proprietorship. In partnership, business is managed and controlled by the partners. Next, the sole proprietor is free to change the partner of manage at time. But in case of partnership, it depends on concern of the partner. Next, the capital investment is managed by proprietor. In case of partnership, the capital investment by the partner is in agreed ratio. Next, the business is unstable. It ends with the death or insolvency of the proprietor. In case of partnership, the business will be relatively more stable than sole proprietorship. The liability for business debits is unlimited in sole proprietorship. In partnership, liability of business debits is unlimited, but it is shared by all partner. In sole proprietorship, it does not share by any person. That profit or that liability is having an own person. Next, joint stock company. The limitation of sole proprietorship and partnership forms a own gave birth of joint stock company forms of organization. Two important limitations of earlier forms of organization were inadequacy of fund and unlimited liability. The earlier form of organization could not meet the increased demand of fund of organization. That's why joint stock company came into force. The other limitation which hampered the growth of business was unlimited liability for owner. That's why joint stock company was first started in Italy in 13th century. During 17th and 18th centuries, joint stock company were formed in England under the royal character or acts of parliament. Definition: it is an voluntary association formed by some person for profit with a capital divided into transformable share having a corporeal body and a common seal.